Hello, my dear children. This is the module 7 of the unit SQL. In this module, we are going to discuss about creating a table without constraints. What are the constraints of SQL? Creating a table with constraints? Show tables? Describe the table structure. This is the syntax and example of creating a table without constraints. Look at the syntax to create a table. Here, create is a clause, create is a command, table is a clause, table name and all other details are arguments of a table clause. So, create table, table name, column name, data type. Here the data type specifies the type of the value a column can have. The size indicates that how many digits or characters can be in a value of a particular column. Each columns are separated with a comma. While we are giving the column description, we need to start an open single parenthesis, and at the end we need to close it with a closing parenthesis. Then we have to end all the queries using a semicolon. So what is the syntax? Create table, table name, column name, data type. Size also we need to put in brackets. So each columns have to be separated with a comma. Look at the example given here. Create table employee. Employee is the table name. What are the columns we are creating? EMPNO, that is employee number, name, department and the salary. Look at the type of each. EMPNO having the type as int. Int indicates, as we discussed earlier, int indicates integer numbers. Varchar for both alphanumeric values. Department also varchar. Then salary, here we are giving with the int again. So integers can be reside in a particular salary column. Then look at another example. Create table student. Create table student role int. Here the role indicates role number of a particular student. Name of a student. Stream, that is nothing but you may be in biology or a computer science or commerce. So stream indicates that thing only. So then per, that is percentage. So here we can enter the records with the role number, name, stream and the percentage of many students. So I think you're all clear about how to create a table without constraints. Here I didn't mention any constraints. So if we want to create, we can also create a table with the constraints and without constraints. In the lab, you normally create a table without constraints. How to view the table structure? After creating the table, you can give the describe command. Describe command. So look at here. Here they are describing the table named ABC Limited. ABC Limited. Okay. ABC LTD, that table is already created. So it indicates the field. Field is nothing but the column names. How many column names in the ABC Limited table? There are 4, that is EMPNO, name, department and salary. EMPNO, so what is the details of a particular column? You have to look horizontally. What are the columns? You have to look vertically. That's all. Okay, so field name, then type, then null. We can enter null values. Here primary key. Primary key indicates it should be not null and it should be unique. That's all. Then default. For department, they had created marketing as default. Then salary we can enter as null. So here, why we are studying all these things? To view in the table structure. What comment we can use it for? DESE or describe. Both we can use. Okay. While we are using describe comment, it will display the table structure along with the column names, each column name's data type, constraints, and default values along with its size. I think you're all clear about how to view a table structure. So while after creating the table, you need to describe the table like this. In the command prompt, you have to type like this. Then, how to drop a table? Drop table, that is drop table if exist table name. You can give if exist. If employees doesn't exist, so you have to check whether it is exist or not. So there are two syntaxes you can give. That is, drop is a comment, table is a clause, emp is an argument. Emp is the name of a table. Also, you can include the clauses like if exist, table if exist. So after checking whether it is existing or not, then it will be deleting from the entire database. So this is the command for dropping a table. Then coming to the next, constraints of SQL. Constraints are nothing but the additional properties of a column. So how the values of a column must be. There are some rules and regulations we can give. While the user enter data into a particular column, the compiler automatically checks the constraints. It is nothing but a check or a condition for a particular column value. While we are entering a value, the compiler will check the condition whether the value satisfies or not. So that is called constraints. Constraints are check or a condition for a column value. So how many types of constraints we are having? Primary key, unique key, then not null, then default, then check and foreign key. There are six constraints we need to study about. The first one, primary key, ensures unique value in any column, also forces data entry mandatory. Only one primary key can be applied in one table. One table can have only one primary key. And while we are giving a primary key constraint, the compiler will check whether the value is unique. It should not have any copies, duplicates, Xerox in the particular column. Along with, it should not be a null value. So that is in the first line, ensures the value in any column and also forces the data entry mandatory. That means we have to enter the data in that particular column if it is having any primary key constraint. Normally we will give the first column as primary key. For example, employee number, role number, product ID, department ID, location ID. Like that we have to give primary key constraint for uniqueness. Then the next one is unique. Also allows unique value in any column, but it allows null values also. It will check only whether the value is unique or not. We can also give null values, but the primary key won't allow us to enter null values, whereas unique will allow us to null value. Then not null. Not null, it will make data entry mandatory for applied column. That is, null will not be allowed. If we are trying to give a value as null into a particular column which is having not null constraint, it won't allow. That is, the compiler won't allow us to enter. Then what is the speciality or what is the difference between other two? Not null value allow duplicates. It doesn't allow only null values. Then the default value, it allows to specify any value which will be automatically inserted in applied column if we not specified column at the time of data entry using insert. While we are inserting any column value, at that time if we forget any values to enter, while at the creation of table we can give default value for particular column. For example, age of a person. If you are entering your age, it will collect your age. That is, it will allow us to give our age. If you are not giving, but you had set default value as 18. If you are creating a voters table, consider if you are creating a voters table, okay, so that it will allow you to enter your own age. And if you are forget or if you forget about to enter your age, at that time the compiler will automatically add 18, that is by the use of default constraint. Then coming to the next, that is check constraint. It allows to specify range of values that can be entered in applied column, like salary must be greater than 2000, marks must be greater than 0, or department must be given in the list of values. So if we want to check any condition before the entry or updation, then we need to use check constraint. Normally check constraint won't be available in MySQL. It is available in Oracle, SQL 2018, everything, but check constraint, that MySQL database engine will ignore the check constraints normally. That means you couldn't do that particular thing as a practical. Okay, then the foreign key allows to establish relationship between the two columns or two tables. Foreign key column will be dependent on primary key column of another table and allows to enter only those values in a foreign key. Those corresponding values exist in the primary key. So, the foreign key allows us to enter the values in a primary key column of another table. So, that two tables get related with the foreign key constraint. My dear children, we will discuss all these types of constraints with examples in the upcoming modules. So, what are the types of constraints we studied? Primary key, unique, not null, default, check, and foreign key. Within this, check is not ignored by MySQL compiler. I think you are all clear about that is how to create a table without constraints, how to drop a table, how to view the table structure, and what are the constraints available in SQL. Thank you.